There's an incredible concept in the Russian martial artist system, which I have always loved, because whenever you actually start practicing this breathing concept, it will remind you of just how resilient you can be under physical stress. Now, the idea here is we're going to perform something called continuous breathing. I mean, most people go, well, I'm breathing all the time. Isn't that continuous breathing? Yeah, I get it. But if you actually look at the neurology of breathing, built into our brainstem is what's called a respiratory pause. There is a natural period when we're breathing where our brain actually stops firing, our brainstem neurons stop firing, so there's a pause in our respiration to kind of let things balance out. Now, that is a fantastic inherent tool of the human nervous system that works great whenever we're not under a lot of physical stress. But whenever we are under physical stress, most people respond to that stress by holding their breath, which means that they begin to extend that respiratory pause, which begins to mess up their blood gas chemistry, which impacts their resilience and their endurance. So a way to combat that is to practice a continuous breathing method. And it's exactly what it sounds like. You're going to breathe in and out in one continuous flow without a pause. So I want you to set your stopwatch or whatever, set it for 1 minute. And your only job for the first minute is just to breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth with no pause. And it's gonna feel odd because we are, in most cases, people are so accustomed to that brief little, okay, pause and begin my exhale or whatever, that trying to breathe continuously can sometimes feel a little bit threatening. And that's what you have to identify in this first minute. Does this feel weird? Is it uncomfortable? If it is, you can change the pattern. You can breathe a little slower, you can breathe a little faster, you can increase the inhale size. You can decrease it. You have to figure out what is somewhat comfortable for you. One of the big errors I often see is that people go, they start off with these really giant inhales and really giant exhales, which take too long. And as a result, then whenever we try to do this more continuously while we're in motion, they begin to suffer some air hunger. So I would encourage you to kind of keep this in the 50 to 60% full inhale, 50 to 60% full exhale range, and just focus on the continuous nature of it. Now, once you've done that, you want to begin adding movement to it. The way that I will typically have people do this is grab a metronome, don't have to have one. If you have one, set it for about 60 beats per minute, and you're going to begin doing simple mobility drills using a continuous breath cycle. So I begin, let's say I'm doing cervical rotations. I'm breathing in. And there's no pause between my inhale and my exhale. You start off with something simple like that. Maybe it's shoulder circles. You don't have to make it exaggerated. You don't have to make it make a lot of noise. This is a kind of an internal process of you paying attention to your breath while you're moving. Now, those are simple examples. You train it using that, and then we actually want you to feel how to use this under load to improve your endurance and resilience. So from here, the next thing I would recommend is set your timer for maybe 2 to 3 minutes, and you're going to begin doing a body weight training cycle. And that could be something as simple as I'm going to do bodyweight squats, and then I'm going to switch into lunges, and then I'm going to do push-ups. I don't care what you choose, but your goal is to do 3 minutes of continuous, non-stop bodyweight exercises while maintaining the continuous breathing flow. Now, if you're a yoga practitioner, maybe you do that in sun salutations. If you are a Pilates practitioner, maybe you do this in, you know, something in ground series. If you're a martial artist, maybe you are doing this while you are shadow boxing, and it's different because we're not trying to always exhale whenever we're making impact. Now, all of a sudden, I'm just trying to breathe continuously as I'm moving. I don't care what you do, but I want it to begin to challenge you, challenge your endurance levels a little bit. What a lot of our students find is that whenever they can master this, all of a sudden they will see or feel what feels like a 2 to 3 times increase in how long they can continue an activity before they begin fatiguing. It's really, really fascinating. And like I said, it's tied into our physiology and the stress of movement. Our natural physiology says pause. We add some stress, some tension, that pause gets extended, and all of a sudden we begin to go into air hunger. And when we go into air hunger, our brain's like, that's threatening, let's stop. Continuous inhale, exhale is an amazing way to solve that problem. It is a technique that is absolutely worth spending time on, because when you master it, I think you're going to see a huge change. So give it a shot. Let us know how it goes for you. If you're new to Z Health, this is just one aspect of what we do. We're a brain-based education company. We specialize in training doctors, coaches, and therapists from around the world. So if you're interested in blending brain-based approaches into what you're already awesome at, check out our channel, subscribe, and check out all of our free resources. We look forward to working with you.